feet on higher ground. Plant my.
Praise the Lord, everybody. We are awake and alive this morning. Though we're awake and alive this morning, though we're inviting each and every one of you to this worship experience, we bring before you an eye-opening experience for our church, not only for our church, but for everyone, as we come to the understanding that life is so fragile. And we wake up each morning and we say, well, Lord, we want to thank you for life. And today, we wake up and we say, Lord, we're doubly thanking you for life because you just never know. Yesterday, in the afternoon, one of our family members from our church passed. Our dear Sister Sue was riding on her bike coming back from Philly and had a terrible accident. We are just so saddened because she was one of those many people who would be online with us. And she's not with us today. Going to the hospital late at night with our other pastor, deeply regret that we have to give our church this kind of information. So today when we say that we're grateful for life and that we're grateful for what God has given us, we simply want to say we are grateful. And so as we welcome you to this 29th day of Bible Boot Camp, we welcome you to this worship experience, but our hearts are heavy and our hearts are hurting at this time. And so we ask you that you pray for the family of Sue Miller. We ask you that you pray and the strength that's needed in our family today. We ask for those who are far away from us, who join our church in this 30 days of Bible Boot Camp, that you pray for our church family and pray for her family and come to understand that God loves us so much and he expects us to live our lives the way we ought to live because we never know when our last day is here. We ask that you bow your heads with me as we go into another day of Bible Boot Camp. We're also asking that as we pray today, that we will just dedicate this Bible Boot Camp to a special friend, to Sue Miller. Let's bow our heads together. Today, Heavenly Father, we come before you. Thank you for all that you've done. We thank you for life and for strength. And today, we thank you for life. We ask you now, Lord, that as we worship you, that though our hearts are hurting, that today we will come to know you as our personal Savior. And so we ask you to continue to bless not only our church, but bless our lives and bless the Miller family at this time. That right now, Lord, as they need comforting, as our church need comforting, as we all need comforting, that we'll get that comfort from your Holy Spirit. So today, Lord, we put our hands in your hands. In Jesus' name. Amen. And so today, we welcome you to our 29th day of Bible Boot Camp. And today, we're going to spend our time just in a word. And after this word, we spend our time with just some songs that will bring us along the way. And so today, I want to share with you that God can do all things. God can comfort in any situation. And so if you don't mind today that we don't have like that regular burst of energy, I don't have that regular burst of energy today. But because we are listening and we are alive and we're wherever we are right now, we acknowledge that God is still a God that's in control. Today, we simply want to say that we live our lives on higher ground. we live our lives on higher ground because we just never know what the next day is going to bring or what life is going to bring. So we live our lives the way we ought to live it. And for those who are hurting, we're going to go back to our prayer. Our prayer that simply says, Lord, calm my heart and my soul today. So many things are out of my control and I need your love to soothe me and to calm me. Your love lets me know that it will be okay. And today, we need that kind of encouragement that everything is going to be okay. And so today, we just want to thank again Praise Vision for just powering us up this morning. We want to thank all those who have been a part of this worship experience. We know we have one more day left. We have one more day left, but today I ask for special prayer, not just for the Sioux family, for my church, Restoration Praise Center. And though we're driven by the Holy Spirit and building by His grace, we're still a church that needs your prayers today more than ever before. And so right now, we want to just share a special song with you. But before we do that, I wanted to bring a scripture to light. The Bible tells us in 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13 through 18, how we ought to comfort one another. And we ought to comfort one another with these words from the Word of God. The Bible tells us, but we ought not be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as those who have no hope. The Bible says, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. The word is clear when it says, for this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. The Bible says we ought to comfort one another with these words. I really believe that this Jesus understands our hurt. I believe this Jesus understands that whatever hurt we're going through, whether it's death, whether it's death to a relationship, whether it's death to our finances, whatever it may be, that God is the kind of God that can understand what we're going through. But today we realize what the Word of God teaches us, that this life is not it. There's something coming. There is this afterlife with Jesus forever. And when He comes, we all have that opportunity of being with Him. We believe and know that in order for us to move to higher ground, we've got to be in His Word. We've got to be stronger than we've ever been in His Word. Today is that day that God is saying, I need you to move to higher ground. God is asking us not only for us to be on higher ground, but He tells us how. He tells us how by getting into His Word, by reading His Word, by understanding His Word, by knowing His Word. And so today is one of those days where we recognize that being strong and being on higher ground and moving from a level of where you were to where you are to where you can be, it takes a personal relationship with God. You see, the Bible tells us it's appointed once for man to die, all of us. But it's not really when you die. The truth is how you die. God is expecting each one of us to die right. So when you look at this text again, and this text that simply tells us that we have hope, we don't cry like others. We are not sad like others because we believe that there's another day coming. The first thing God is asking us today to believe is that He rose again. The next thing He wants us to understand is how this whole thing is going to take place. In verse 16, it says, "For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God." And the Bible tells us that the dead in Christ shall rise first. So our aim is that if we should pass, we should die, that we will rise in the first resurrection. And the Bible says, "And then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet him in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord." The Bible says we ought to comfort one another with these words. Today, we ask you that if God has given you life today, how do you repay him today? We repay him by living the way we ought to live, by being the Christians that he wants us to be, by being that awesome individual through his word. And so today, I understand that someone is hurting. Our church is hurting, but we still have this amazing grace. Let's watch this as we begin our comfort this morning. That's the kind of grace we will be needing. That's the kind of grace that we want. Amazing grace. And so I want to play this song for each one of you today. A song that will just take us throughout the day. And I ask you today that we be that praying type of family. Now, I need you to know that tomorrow is our last day. But I ask you to just understand that we are now a part of a service or now a part of a worship experience that needs a double portion of God's Holy Spirit. Today, we ask you to be in full prayer for our church family and for the Miller family. And so I wanted to just play this song for you. And as we pray this song, I also ask that you take on the picture of the day. And we end today our worship time, knowing that though somber, that God wants us to move to higher ground simply because he wants us to be saved in this kingdom. We don't know today what Sue's, where she would be. See, that's between her and her God. The question today is, where would we be? Where does God want us to be? And so we live our lives on higher ground so that we'll live closer to him. So when he comes, we will be saved. this song I want to share with you is a song that says, "This is the air that I breathe." So today, breathe in the Holy Spirit. We'll come back and we'll pray together, knowing that God is still in control today.
This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. whispered for you.
Without you. And so I want to leave the picture of the day with you. Picture of the day that simply says to each one of us, this picture of the day, that only God can fill an empty heart. And as your heart is hurting right now, it's important, so important, that we rely on Christ, who is the author and finisher of our faith. And so as we close today, we remind you of refill. We remind you of refill. We remind you of water for the thirsty. We ask you to just support us in this ministry. Just support us. Just go to our Facebook and support us. Just buy a shirt and be a part of this worship experience. And today we just simply say to hold on to God's unchanging hand. So Father, today we come before you thanking you for all that you've done. We thank you for life, and we thank you for the opportunity of knowing such a beautiful person. And today, Lord, we just simply ask you that you'll be with every individual. Today our prayer request is that you comfort those who have loved this person. Comfort her family, comfort us the best way that you can. And so today we simply ask that your Holy Spirit will bless us and guide us and roll with us today, knowing that life is so precious and so are you. And so we leave this song as a tribute to our friend. We ask, Lord, that our song will be your song. So today, Lord, we thank you for being a good God. And though we don't understand what life brings sometimes, we do know this much, that you're still in control. So today, we are still grateful that we have life, which means what next comes? What next? That we live the way you ask us to live, on higher ground. Today, we ask for your blessings, in Jesus' name, amen. Today, we just simply say goodbye to a very special friend.
What if it's God speaking?
stranger who already knew your name. What if it's him? What if it's God speaking? Do you know?